Hi everybody, I'm Mike here at Global Village. First, thank you so much to all my previous students for your kind comments. I really appreciate that and I miss all of you very much. Hope you're doing well. And if you guys are still studying English, I want to do a little review and for other people to explain the importance of idioms and phrasal verbs. What are idioms? Idioms are phrases that have a double meaning. First, there is the literal or true meaning, and then there is also a figurative meaning. For example, most people know the phrase a piece of cake. A piece of cake can literally or truly mean a slice of cheesecake, or it can mean something very easy or simple. So when you finish your first level test in Global Village, you would say, that was a piece of cake. That's an example of an idiom. Phrasal verbs are also idioms, but they contain a verb and a preposition. One example could be look up. Now look up can literally or really mean look up in the sky, or it can mean to search or find information. For example, you don't know the meaning of a word, you can look it up on the internet, which nowadays people usually say Google, but when you Google something, you are looking it up. Now, sometimes students say, are idioms slang? And my answer is no. Slang is more appropriate for the street, and that could be an example of something like the word sick, which does mean ill, but can also mean great. So like my friend Mark Rankin, the guitar player, is a sick guitar player, okay? But he's not ill, he's just very good. But that language is maybe not appropriate for a TOEFL test, just for the street. So I try to help my students understand the difference between idioms, phrasal verbs, and slang. Idioms and phrasal verbs are common in all kinds of English, and they should help you to improve your English too.